How should Christians deal with doubt in their lives? We experience doubt all the time, and doubt seems to just be a part of life in general, not just a part of the Christian life and a life that is purposed to follow Jesus. This video is kind of an unscripted, just me talking in front of the camera kind of video. I literally just turned the camera on because I just want to kind of express the idea of doubt and how to deal with doubt in the Christian life. When it comes to doubt, I think there's two types of doubt. There's good doubt and there's bad doubt. Good doubt is the kind of doubt that gets you thinking and helps you ask deep questions. It's the kind of doubt that gets you to understand the world around you and the why behind your life a whole lot better than if you didn't have that doubt in the first place. I would argue that you're not really a thoughtful person, a person who thinks about life and about purpose and about meaning, unless you actually have doubts in your life. So when it comes to the Christian life, it's really important to express those questions that you might have about the Bible or about Jesus or about yourself and humanity and the world around you and articulate that doubt to somebody else. Because it's not good to have that doubt inside of you. It's good to actually express that doubt to other people because they might actually have answers to some of the questions that you have. And the second kind of doubt is the bad doubt. It's the skeptical doubt. It's easy just to stay in your doubt for a long time because the purpose of doubt is to investigate what the truth is. And if you've investigated to the fullest extent your doubt and what the truth is, yet you're still skeptical, then that's what I would call bad doubt. You're not choosing to make a decision whether for or against Christianity, for or against the question that you might have. So I just think there's two types of doubt, and doubt isn't necessarily a bad thing. There's a really good Christian philosopher named Dallas Willard who has a really good way of dealing with doubt, and he deals with it like this. You need to believe your doubts and believe your beliefs, doubt your doubts, and doubt your beliefs. That sounds kind of crazy, but in a sense, it's cyclical learning. It's cyclical questioning. It means that you don't take anything for granted. You question everything, yet you don't live in that life of questioning. You don't live in a skeptical life. You ask the deep questions of life, try and find answers to those questions, try and be a critical thinker your entire life, yet once those questions have been satisfied, you need to actually believe and live out the result and the conclusion of those answers. I don't know if this video helped anyone, and it's just kind of a rambly video, unscripted, but if you thought that this video was any good, then please hit the subscribe button, and if you thought this video could help anyone out there you know, then please share it along, and don't forget to always live intentionally.